Day at the lake turns tragic when a toxic algae claims the lives of several beloved pets. Missouri and Illinois scientists are now monitoring that algae.
Now, it hasn't been observed in the St. Louis metro area lately, but as Fox 2's Katie Corman reports, the conditions are ripe for the blooms to pop up anywhere.
An afternoon spent cooling off in a North Carolina pond. Hours later, Melissa Martin's three dogs were dead.
People need to know about this. Like I said, if we had any clue that this was a thing, they would have never come. I had no idea.
2 days later, Brittany Stanton took her dog, Ollie, to a lake in Texas. Within an hour of getting out of the water, Stanton says Ollie's legs gave out and he began to seize. He died on the way to the animal hospital. In both cases, experts point to a toxic blue-green algae which blooms in excess when conditions are right.
That typically happens when the weather gets hot, like in July and August. It typically happens in bodies of water that aren't moving, like lakes and ponds.
Dan Zarlango with Missouri Department of Conservation says nutrient-rich waste from fertilizer and livestock may add to the rapid growth. There's been one report of blue-green algae in the St. Louis metro this year, found in a subdivision lake in Jefferson County. Blue-green algae can impact pets, livestock, and people, with effects ranging from a mild rash to liver damage and even death. There have been no illnesses reported in Missouri this year. Kyle Smith spends hours each week training his dog Cooper.
Good boy.
Through the North American Versatile Hunting Dog Association.
There is a water aspect, so I'm trying to get him used to getting in the water and lots of different locations.
Blue-green algae can be hard to spot because, unlike its name suggests, it can come in a variety of colors, from green to blue to red to brown, and it can appear thick or like spilled paint. Chemical testing is needed to know for sure.
If I am concerned about the way a body of water looks, I'll just keep them out of it. I mean, when you put this much work into a dog, it's better safe than sorry.
Good boy.
Experts say when in doubt, stay out. The Department of Natural Resources depends on people to alert them to possible toxic algae blooms. There are several ways to make a report. Look for the links in this story in your Fox 2 and News 11 apps. Reporting from Jefferson County, I'm Katie Corman.